Good morning, friends. In this session, let me explain the concept of stresses and helical springs of circular wire. So this is a compression helical spring. Right, which is loaded with a compressive load of magnitude W. Right, the diameter, let the diameter of the coil is a capital D here. Right, since the helical spring is made up of a circular wire wound in the form of a helix, right? So right, since the wire is wound in the form of a coil, and the coil is, each coil is having its center, and if you draw a line passing through all these centers, you will get the axis, and the load is acting along the axis of the spring, then this load is a compressive load, and the coils are subjected to deflection. Obviously, all the coils are come in contact with each other, then this load W induces certain amount of twisting moment or the torque on the spring wire cross section. So that twisting moment W is equal to load W into the radius of the coil, that is W into D by 2, then T is equal to W into D by 2. This twisting moment or the torque induces certain amount of shear stress. That shear stress is designated with tau 1. Tau 1 is equal to 16 T by pi D cube, because when a circular member is subjected to a torque or the twisting moment or a torsion, you can use your torsion equation, T by J equal to tau by R equal to G theta by L. So from that equation, you will get tau is equal to 16 T by pi D cube. So you just substitute the value of T in this tau equal to 16 T by pi D cube, then 16 into W into D by 2 divided by pi D cube, 2 8s are 16, and then you can rewrite this as torsional shear stress, tau 1 is equal to 8WD by pi D cube. So apart from this torsional shear stress, the spring is also subjected to two more types of stresses. One is shear stress due to direct shear stress due to load W, and the second one is shear stress due to curvature. So we will consider the first one, direct shear stress. Right, when do you get the direct stress, or when do you consider direct shear stress? When the member is subjected to a load, and if the cross section of that member is parallel to the load, then the member is subjected to directional shear stress. Here in this case, the load is along the axis of the member, and since the wire is wound in the form of a helix, and almost every coil under the deflection or under the deformation is parallel to the ground or perpendicular to the axis. That means the cross section is parallel to the load. Parallel to the axis or the load. When the load is parallel to the cross section, obviously, what type of stress induced in the member? It is shear stress, right? So when the load is parallel to the cross section of the member, then the shear stress induced in the member is called direct shear stress. So here also, direct shear stress is equal to tau 2. Direct shear stress tau 2 is equal to load divided by cross sectional area. What is the cross sectional area for a circular cross section? Pi by 4 d square. That is equal to 4W divided by pi d square. 4W divided by pi d square. Okay, so this is torsional shear stress and this is direct shear stress. Let us take a tau 1 here. This is tau 2. Okay, now if you consider the distribution of this stresses, this, so I will give you the stress distribution. We will have the stress distribution of tau 1, that is the direct torsional shear stress. It is like this. Right, so this is the cross section of the wire. Right, at the center it is zero. So this is diameter of the wire. It is not coil diameter, it is wire diameter. Right, so you will get maximum shear stress at the edges of the wire cross section. Okay, at the center it is zero. At the center it is, when the radius is zero, right, the shear stress is zero. So this is the distribution of torsional shear stress. Similarly, if you consider the distribution of direct shear stress, right, so when the load is acting in this direction, the bottom portion also subjected to the compressive load. Right, once again, this also along the cross section of the wire. So this is center and this is outer edge, this is inner edge, this is inner edge, or if you want, you can mark this is outer edge, this is inner edge. Right, so this is once again D. Now this is the stress distribution of direct shear stress and this is the stress distribution of torsional shear stress. Now if you combine the stress distributions of torsional shear stress and direct shear stress, you will get the overall shear stress distribution of the shear stress distribution of helical spring. Okay, now you combine here. So the, here the shear stress is vertically upwards and here also it is vertically upwards, but here it is vertically upwards, here it is vertically downwards. So that's why the inner edge of the circular spring, the inner edge of the, or the inner diameter of the helical spring is subjected to more amount of shear stress. That's why if you consider the stress distribution, you will get, you take the combination of these two, you will get, once again, you will get the stress distribution like this. Right? One is if you combine these two, the inner edge is subjected to more amount of stress. Inner edge. This is inner edge and this is outer edge, and somewhere here you will have the axis of the spring. This is the axis of the spring. This is center of the wire. Okay, so right, this is the overall distribution of the shear stress, that is torsional shear stress. This is tau 1 and this is tau 2. Now this is tau 1 plus tau 2. That means the inner edge is subjected to more amount of shear stress, right, and the outer edge is subjected to less amount of shear stress. Okay, now if you consider the mathematical formula of this combined shear stress, you can add this tau is equal to tau 1 plus tau 2. Tau 1 plus tau 2. So here instead of plus, you need to consider plus or minus 2, plus or minus tau 2. Plus sign is used for the inner edge and minus sign is used for the plus sign is for inner edge. And minus sign is for outer edge. Right? So tau 1 is equal to 8WD divided by pi d cube plus or minus, or then you will get 4W divided by pi d square. Okay, so we are going to find out the maximum stress, right? We are going to find out maximum stress. That's why you consider plus sign here. Then you write this equation 8WD divided by pi d cube as common factor into 1 plus d by 2D. Right? So in this case, 2 4s, then you will get 4 here, dd cancel, you will get w, d cancel with this one of the d here, then you will get pi d square. Then 1 plus, that is equal to 8wd divided by pi d cube into 1 plus 1 by 2c. Capital D by small d is called, capital D by small d is called spring index, right? So since C is equal to capital D by small d. Okay, then 1 plus 1 by 2C. Now you can consider this as K, some factor K, that is called shear stress factor. Let us take this is KS. Then this equation can be rewritten as KS into 8WT divided by pi d cube. Right? So this is equal to tau. Tau is equal to 8WT divided by pi d cube. Is it okay? So tau is equal to Ks into 8WD divided by pi d cube. This is maximum shear stress induced in the spring. So this is a torsional shear stress, this is direct shear stress, and this is equal to maximum shear stress. Maximum shear stress induced. But here we are not consider the curvature effect into account. If you consider the curvature effect also into account, then this shear stress is slightly increased, because when you wound the wire in the form of a spring, right, the wire is bent into the curved shape. When you wound this, or when you bend the wire into curved shape, obviously it is induced with certain amount of stress. That stress also taken into the account, then that is called the stress due to curvature. Okay, then this value is slightly increased. This value is slightly increased, thereby this Ks can be modified into K. The Ks can be modified as K, then tau is equal to K into 8WD divided by pi d cube. 8WD divided by pi d cube, where K is wall stress factor. K is equal to Ks into Kc. Ks into Kc. This K is called wall stress factor. which considers the effect of both direct shear, right, then stress due to curvature, right? This is wall stress factor, that is equal to K is equal to 4C minus 1 divided by 4C minus 4 plus 0.615 divided by C. 0.615 divided by C. This is wall stress factor. Okay, so that's how you can find out the stress induced in the helical spring. So firstly, you need to consider stress due to torsion or the twisting moment, then stress due to direct shear, and then the combination of these two stresses, you will get maximum stress, that is tau equal to tau 1 plus tau 2. You will get a plus sign for the inner edge and minus sign for the outer edge, because the inner edge is subjected to maximum stress. So this is stress due to torsion and this is stress due to direct shear. If we combine these two, you will get the stress distribution like this. The inner edge is subjected to maximum stress and the outer edge is subjected to somewhat lower value of stress, right? Then you will get the equation as tau equal to Ks into 8wd by pi d cube. Now if you consider the curvature also, curvature effect also into the consideration, then the Ks is replaced with another stress factor called a wall stress factor, right? And this can be expressed in terms of spring index, 4c minus 1 divided by 4c minus 4 plus 0.615 by c, right? And this considers the effect of both shear as well as curvature effect. That's why wall stress factor is equal to shear stress factor into curvature factor. Shear stress factor already we have calculated here, that is equal to 1 plus 1 by 2c, and the curvature factor also taken into account here, then you will get wall stress factor. Now here onwards, the stress in the helical spring, compression helical spring, you can write tau is equal to K into 8wd divided by pi d cube. That's how you can find out the shear stress in the helical spring. I think it is clear, right? Thank you.